this text message that just says no service in Yosemite. What were the last words that you spoke to your daughter?
We were working on her website. You know, she was telling me about the trip, where she was going, and you know, all this other stuff. She, you know, said, "Listen, I'm going to have some bad reception, you know, in certain spots. So I'll call you when I can. You know, I'll let mom know I'm going to be calling her." All right, cool. You know, and then we were working on a website and trying to. She had some problems making the email address work. You know, for Nomadic Static that she was doing. So I'm not a techie guy. But I sat down at my computer and we YouTubed it and we figured it out together. You know, I sent her some food through my Domino's app and we were just laughing, having a good time, you know, trying to make it work. It was frustrating off the start when we couldn't get the email to work, but we got it.
Okay, and that was when?
That was on the 21st of August.
All right.
Because me and Gabby talk once, twice a week. Her mom speaks to her 2-3 times a week. My son talks to her, you know, a couple times a week. So. You know, it's always someone talking to her, and you're like, oh, no, I haven't, you know. And you don't think anything, you're just traveling the country. But then it started to become a week. You know, now it's 10, now we got a problem. You know what I mean? Now you're 10 days, you know what I mean? We got a problem, you know, and that's when it was it.
During that time, he never called you. He never said, hey, just so you know, I'm home with your daughter's van, but not your daughter. She's out there in America somewhere. I just left. She went off with some people, or she's in a hotel. Zero.
No, nothing. Gabby's mom last talked to her physically on the 25th.
Right.
On the 30th, she hears, you know, she gets a text message that there's not a lot of service in Yosemite. She, you know, you can think it's an autocorrect or whatever. You don't think anything of it, you know, but then come the, you know, the first, the second, third, the fourth, the fifth, you're not hearing from her. All right, because you're camping, there's not a lot of service. I'll hear from her in a couple of days. And then, you know, you let two days more go by. Now you start calling people and stuff like that. You're like, all right, maybe, you know, whatever. And then we tried on the 10th to do, like I said, the missing person. We finally got it in on the 11th. You know what I mean? So, like, it just became too much.
Did you call Brian during or at the end of this 10 days?
We called Brian. We called the mom. We called the dad. We called the sister. We called every number we could find. And we got no phone calls were picked up. No text messages were returned. So we texted them. Have you seen our kids? You know, we haven't heard from them, you know, in a while. We're getting really nervous. And we're about to call the police. And you think when someone says they're about to call the police to find your missing kid, you would return a phone call? I mean, that's just what logic would dictate for normal people. And you don't get any response? I mean, that just makes it more and more concerning, doesn't it?
So mom, dad, sister, Brian, nobody took your calls?
No one. We'll be right back.